D-A-N-I-M-A-L-S. Danimals.
Arthur is made possible in part by the makers of Danimals yogurt, proud to help foster the growth and development of kids everywhere.
Chuck E. Cheese's, proud supporter of PBS KIDS, helping children discover the fun of developing their bodies and their minds. PBS KIDS, where a kid can be a kid.
And by a ready-to-learn television cooperative agreement from the U.S. Department of Education through the Public Broadcasting Service. And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Arthur on PBS 39 was made possible in part by...
Most Precious Blood School open enrollment is going on right now, offering small class sizes for preschoolers and students in grades K through 8. Hot lunches plus before and after school care are available on site. More at 424-4832 or preciousblood.org.
You are watching PBS KIDS on WFWA 39, Fort Wayne.
The following program on Kids 39 is made possible in part by...
People are moving to Magic 95.1, WAJI. Magic 95.1.
I'm not crazy, I'm just a little unwell.
At work, in the car, and at home.
This love has taken its toll.
The 90s, today, and the 80s. They're moving to Magic 95.1 WAJR.
Derva. That's Finnish for hello. Say it with me. Derva. Great job. Today is a special day because it's show and tell, and it's Hooper's turn to bring something from home to share with everyone.
Hi, Miss Lori. Did you know today is show and tell, and it's my turn?
Absolutely. I'm curious, Hooper, what did you bring?
You'll never guess.
Let's try and guess what Hooper brought. Give us one hint, Hooper.
It's big, it lived a long time ago, and its name ends with sore.
Did you get it? Me too. Hooper, did you bring a dinosaur?
That's amazing! You're a good guesser. But it's not just any dinosaur. It's a triceratops. It's got three horns and it ate plants.
That's interesting. I'm sure the other kids will love hearing about it.
It lived 70 million years ago.
And playing with it.
Playing with my triceratops?
Yes, that's a part of show and tell. We talk about our toy and then we share it with the rest of the class.
Share my triceratops?
Sharing is fun. And so is our friend, Curious George.
This program was made possible by...
Sometimes big dreams start small, with a foundation that will last a lifetime. Read to your child 15 minutes a day and inspire them to dream big. Shea Homes, caring since 1881.
Curious George is also brought to you by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Wasn't that fun? Now George gets into things because he's curious. Let's see what these curious kids are into. You never know what sort of monkey business Curious George will get into. Because for this monkey, being curious is his business. Are you curious? Let's visit some kids who are putting their curiosity to work. Today is show and tell, and Hooper brought his favorite dinosaur. But when he heard that he was expected to share his dinosaur, he seemed a little upset. How do you feel when someone asks you to share something you really care about? Well, I think we'll see that sharing can be a really good thing. And that reminds me, you can share all kinds of games with Curious George at pbskids.org. And now, here's Clifford.
This program was made possible by...
Sometimes big dreams start small, with a foundation that will last a lifetime. Read to your child 15 minutes a day and inspire them to dream big. Shea Homes, caring since 1881.
Curious George is also brought to you by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Curious George introduces children to math and science concepts. At PBSParents.org, you can help your child's early math development with the PBS Parents Guide to Early Math. All the tools you need are at PBSParents.org.
Let's go play. Who wants to play?
Come on and play.
How do super friends create super-sized adventures?
We're off to dig up buried treasure.
Just ask Clifford, Cleo, and Tebow.
I'll save you.
Join the dogs of Birdwell Island and Emily Elizabeth, of course.
Let's go, Clifford.
For an extra large helping of fun.
I win.
Join your friend Clifford, the big red dog, next on PBS Kids.
Have I ever steered you wrong?
Coming up next, it's Clifford. Coming up next, it's Clifford on WFWA 39 Fort Wayne.
Local broadcast of Clifford is funded in part by
Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine.
The super hits of the 60s and 70s. WLDE 101.
It looks like you really don't want to share your dinosaur for show and tell.
It's my dinosaur, and I just don't want anything bad to happen to it.
Sometimes it's hard to share something you really care about.
So, why should I share my dinosaur?
Because sharing can be fun. Let me show you.
Look at this.
What's all this, Miss Laurie?
It's something that we can all have lots of fun with.
It is? It doesn't look like much fun. It looks like a bunch of pieces.
They are pieces. And by themselves, they aren't much fun. But let's see what happens when we share all the pieces.
A rocket. Cool.
See? Sharing can be fun. You wouldn't have had fun with just one piece. But now we have a rocket that we can all play with.
But I still have a piece. What's this button for?
Push it and we'll see.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1... Blast off!
Wow! That was great!
And all because we shared.
I think Hooper is beginning to see that sharing can be fun. Now, let's visit Clifford, the big red dog.
Clifford is funded in part by a Ready to Learn television cooperative agreement from the U.S. Department of Education through the Public Broadcasting Service.
Chuck E. Cheese's, proud supporter of PBS Kids. Helping kids exercise their right to have fun, learning new things. PBS Kids, where a kid can be a kid.
And by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and from viewers like you.
Today we're talking about sharing. Hooper's not sure that he wants to share his dinosaur.
Well, Hooper, I see that you took the tape off your dinosaur.
Well, my dinosaur doesn't like tape. Hey, Miss Laurie, what do you call a dinosaur that never gives up?
I don't know.
A triceratops. Get it? Triceratops.
Great joke, Hooper. Thanks for sharing. Now let's get back to Clifford, the big red dog.
We're talking about sharing today, and I have something I want to share with you. It's somewhere in my purple possibility bag. Nope, that's not it. That's not what I was looking for. I wondered where that went, but that's not it either. That's what I wanted to share with you.
It means there's something for you to do with Emily Elizabeth, Clifford, and all your friends at pbskids.org. Now here's Dragon Tales.
Clifford is funded in part by a Ready to Learn Television Cooperative Agreement from the U.S. Department of Education through the Public Broadcasting Service.
Chuck E. Cheese's, proud supporter of PBS Kids. You know that inside every kid, there's a lot of different kids learning to have fun. PBS Kids, where a kid can be a kid.
And by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and from viewers like you.
Sharing might seem hard sometimes, but when we share, it can be fun. Our friends Rebecca Frezza and Big Truck have a song about sharing they want to share with you.
S-H-A-R-E. If you got something that's special to you, and you share it with a friend, they might think it's special too. The two of you together can find a way to play. You'll be having so much fun.
Dragon Tales and Clifford teach children important social and emotional skills. At PBSParents.org, you can use the Child Development Tracker to find out more about your child's social and emotional growth. All the tools you need are at PBSParents.org.
What's up?
Look, the dragons are calling us to Dragonland.
Make a wish and head to Dragonland for some enchanted and surprising adventures.
It's a magical merry-go-round.
See how some fantastic friends work together, solve problems, and most of all, have fun.
Let's rock and roll!
A wonderful world is waiting for you on Dragon Tales, next on PBS Kids.
Love it! Love it!
Want to check out my treehouse?
Join Snook and all his friends in the World Tree, where you can play, dance, and ask questions.
Can an allergy make you sneeze?
It's a world of adventure and discovery. It's a big, big world. Later on PBS Kids.
Clifford on PBS 39 was made possible in part by...
Oak Farm Montessori School, offering a primary program for children 3 to 6 years old. It's designed to help young children build a sense of order, concentration, coordination, and independence through exploration and experimentation. Oak Farm's primary program teachers provide an early foundation in math, reading, science, geography, history, art, and music. Respect for each other and the environment are also key elements of a Montessori education. Tours are encouraged. Located in a villa, Oak Farm School is just a quick drive from Fort Wayne, serving children from 18 months through middle school.
Lakeside Learning Garden, carrying used and new children's books, videos, and computer software, teaching and parenting resources, craft and activity books, and Christian books and videos. Lakeside Learning Garden also offers morning and evening story and learning times, plus once a month family events, Mom's Night Out and Dad's Night Out. At Lakeside Learning Garden, there's coffee, tea, and cocoa available, plus toys and games for children to play with while parents browse. Lakeside Learning Garden, next to the Tecumseh Branch Library on East State Boulevard in Fort Wayne.
Coming up next, it's Dragon Tales on WFWA 39 Fort Wayne.
We've been talking about sharing. That means there's a great game for you to share with your friends at pbskids.org. Let's play it now with Dash.
You know what? I just made up the funniest song on pbskids.org with Cassie. We made up a song called Dragon Doodle by filling in the song's blanks like this. Bed, hamster, and fish. There. Now let's play our song.
Dragon Doodle went to bed riding on a hamster. Stuck a dragon berry in his hand.
and called it macaroni. Dragon Doodle, keep it up, Dragon Doodle Dandy. Mind the music and the fit done with us, nails be handy.
We can even share that silly song with our friends. And you know what else? At PBSKids.org, there are a lot more games from all your favorite shows. Thanks for playing. Gotta dash.
We're proud to sponsor programs that are good for strong minds and bodies.
Good morning, good morning. The best to you each morning. K-E-double-L-O-double-good Kellogg's. Best to you.
Kellogg's Frosted Flakes cereal. Who reminds you to never stop trying to be your best.
Dragon Tales is funded in part by a grant from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting through funds from the U.S. Department of Education.
Today we're talking about sharing. I want to share a dance with you.
Stand up, everybody, and do what I do. Ready? Moving to the left, and moving to the right. A wiggle and shake with all your might. Spin around. Stamp the ground. Great job, everyone. Thanks for dancing with me. Now here's a song from Dragonland.
We all like it when people share with us, but sometimes it's hard to share with others. Hooper's not sure that he wants to share his favorite dinosaur with the other kids. Have you ever found it hard to share something you really like with someone else? That means that Ord and Cassie and all the other dragons are waiting to share with you at PBSKids.org. It's a Big, Big World is next.
Kellogg's Frosted Flakes cereal, who reminds you to never stop trying to be your best.
We're proud to sponsor programs that are good for strong minds and bodies.
Good morning.
Dragon Tales is funded in part by a grant from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting through funds from the U.S. Department of Education.
Ever wonder how ice cream is made?
Yeah. Let's go to an ice cream factory and see how it's done.
This is an ice cream factory in Indiana. It's the largest packaged ice cream plant in the world. It takes ingredients from all over the world to make great ice cream. They get milk and cream from neighboring cities, candies and cookies from Chicago, pecans from Georgia, almonds from California, cocoa powder from South America, and vanilla. All the way from Madagascar.
It takes a lot more to make ice cream than I thought.
Yeah, but it's worth it.
Edie's Ice Cream and all the employees from the manufacturing plant in Fort Wayne are proud to support PBS 39 and education in our area.
Coming up next, it's a Big, Big World on WFWA 39, Fort Wayne.
Almost time for show and tell, Hooper. Are you ready to talk about your dinosaur?
It's not just a dinosaur, it's a triceratops. Did you know that the horns of a triceratops grow 3 feet long and that they lived in herds like cows?
I always learn something from you, Hooper. Now, Hooper, do you think you're going to share your dinosaur with the other kids?
I'm not sure.
Well, think about it. But now it's time for It's a Big, Big World.
Funding for It's a Big, Big World provided by...
Capture all those shining moments before your kids grow up.
I know that you will.
Brought to you by Sony Handycam and Cybershot Products. Proud sponsor of PBS Kids. Sony.
And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
And its horns are 3 feet long, it ate plants, and it lived 70 million years ago, which is a really long time. So you can see why a Triceratops is one of my favorite dinosaurs.
Thanks for sharing all you know about the dinosaur, Hooper. Do you think that the other kids can play with it now?
I guess so. Here.
Here you go. Hooper, I am very proud that you decided to share one of your favorite toys with the other kids.
Well, dinosaurs make me happy, right?
Right.
So I wanted the other kids to be happy, too. And you know what? When I shared, they were happy, and so was I.
That's wonderful, Hooper. Thanks for sharing that with me, too.
Miss Laurie?
Yes?
Did you know that the Stegosaurus was the size of a bus?
Really? That's very interesting, Hooper. Let's get back to It's a Big, Big World.
It's...
Funding for It's a Big, Big World provided by...
Capture all those shining moments before your kids grow up.
I know that you will.
Brought to you by Sony Handycam and Cybershot Products. Proud sponsor of PBS Kids. Sony.
And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Today, Hoopa shared lots of interesting facts about dinosaurs. And he also shared his dinosaur with the other kids. He didn't want to share his toy at first, but then he did. And he discovered that sharing with others made him happy. Sharing can be a really good thing. Hear that? That means there's something for you from It's a Big, Big World at pbskids.org. Thanks for sharing your time with us. You did a great job today.
It's a Big, Big World helps children learn about science, animals, and discovery. At pbsparents.org, you can discover age-appropriate book suggestions for your child with the Book Finder. All the tools you need are at pbsparents.org.
Are you curious? Curious what it would be like to fly with the birds? Curious what 100 dozen donuts look like? Hey, so is George, because he's Curious George, right here on PBS Kids.
And welcome back to Get Wordy. Now, here's today's double Get Wordy clue. Activities. What nighttime activity involves looking at words and helps children develop a lifelong love of books?
Is it eating cookie?
No, cookie. It has nothing to do with cookies.
Is it reading at bedtime?
Yes, that's right! Reading to your child at bedtime is a great way to help your child develop a lifelong love of reading books. You win!
Get Wordy was brought to you today by PBS Ready to Learn. We're getting kids ready for school and ready for life.